as a parent, you try really hard to be a good role model. Mm-hmm. You watch your language, you don't fly off the handle, and you try not to overindulge. But have you given any thought to showing your little one empathy? Can you even teach it?
Tonight, in our second instalment from child development expert Nathan Wallis, he tells us that learning empathy is an apprenticeship. And here's the part that's really going to ruffle feathers, including mine. He's not a fan of sleep training. We'll assess that after the story. Here's Rachel Parkin.
When you've just turned two and love playing mummy, it doesn't get any better than this. Harriet McKenzie's learned from the best, Mum Jamie.
Can't beat the real thing, eh? You know I've got little eyes watching all the time.
That, says Nathan Wallis, is spot on.
Think of it as an apprenticeship.
His best advice for encouraging empathy? Show them how it's done.
Watching someone treat you empathetically for a couple of years is really what gives you empathy.
Research suggests kids who don't get that really struggle.
Kids that have been raised in an orphanage in the early years have what the literature calls a virtual black hole, where that empathy centre is supposed to be.
Wow, that's harsh. So.
And here's another thing. That good old Kiwiism, she'll be right, mate, doesn't apply to toddlers. Like ever. Even when they're hamming it up. Turns out we should always acknowledge their trips and bumps.
So the school of hard knocks isn't a school you would endorse?
No, no. You actually tolerated that 1% of the time because you had a strong base from the 99% of the time they were loving you and caring for you.
We Harriet here, living proof.
Like, she'll hit her head and we'll be like, oh no, you've hit your head, are you sad, are you sore? Like, yeah, and then she sort of figures out what she's feeling rather than just, oh my God, the world's ending.
I'm sceptical of any strategy that starts with he's got to learn, because it's usually a precursor to abandonment.
Which brings us to Nathan's most controversial piece of advice relating to empathy.
Here's where you ruffle a few feathers.
Don't leave under ones to cry in the name of sleep training.
If he's going to learn to, he or she's going to learn to link their sleep cycles together, being in a bassinet right beside our bed, so that as soon as they start to stir, they get picked up and put on the breast and don't fully wake up and go back to sleep and get put back into bed, I would say that's a baby learning to link their sleep cycles rather than put in a room down the other end of the house and screaming for 20 minutes just teaches you to wake up fully in between the sleep cycles.
So every time he or she cries, you get up, give them a cuddle or a feed.
Yeah, and think, clever baby, knowing to wake up in the middle of the night two or three times in the first year of life.
You're shocking me.
I know.
Nathan knows full well this goes against what's becoming a huge sleep training industry, but says leaving them to cry is counterintuitive to parent-bubba bonding. Something this mini mummy has already got down pat.
Can you say, Hugo, I love you?
Oh, she's gorgeous.
Beautiful.
I know, 50% of you agree with Nathan. 50% of you are going, it is controversial. We ran a poll on our Facebook page earlier on. Do you let your babies cry themselves to sleep? 45% said yes, 55% said no. It is a very contentious issue. I'll put my hand up and say yes, and it worked.
Well,
Jeremy?
It worked for me as well. Well, actually, it worked with one and it didn't work with the other. I think every child is quite different. Mm. But you got to be careful, because if you keep going in, and then they get used to you going in.
There are a lot of rules. Just do your best.
You've got to do your best.
We're just doing our best.
You've got to get through. However you get through,
yeah.
You've got to get through.
You're doing okay.